Good evening, sir. Good evening, classmates. This evening, I will be discussing about discrete random variable and probability distribution function for a discrete random variable. So our objectives for this evening are, first, define random variable. Second, differentiate discrete random variable from continuous random variable. And then third, we have tabulate probability distribution of a discrete random variable. Let's first define what is variable. So a variable is a quantity whose value changes. A variable represents a value, an indefinite value, and it can only be obtained when solving an equation or performing an experiment such as a statistical experiment. There are two types of variable. First, we have discrete variable. A discrete variable is a variable whose quantity is obtained through counting. For example, the number of teachers attended the seminar. Another, the number of students absent for the day. And then the second type of variable is continuous. Continuous variable is a variable whose value is obtained through measuring. For example, the amount of sugar that will be put in a coffee. Another, we have the amount of flour that will be put in a bread mixture. Now let's define random variable. Random variable is a numerical description of the outcome of a statistical experiment. So random variable is a variable which result from a random experiment in statistics and other experiment such as scientific experiment. So there are two types of random variable. We have discrete random variable and continuous random variable. Discrete random variable is one which may take only a countable number of distinct values such as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so forth. So discrete random variable is a random variable that only takes whole number. So this random variable is the number of outcome that you expect from a statistical experiment, and it can only take whole number. You cannot have decimal in it. And next we have continuous random variable. Continuous random variable is one that may assume any value in some interval on the real number line. Meaning, unlike discrete random variable that only takes whole number in the number line, continuous random variable may take any number on the interval. So, it could have decimal on it. So, the outcome that you expect may have decimal in it. For example, for discrete variable, you will have, let's say, the number of teachers present in the seminar. So, the number of attendees will be whole number. So, let's say, for example, there are 20 attendees or there are 40 attendees. Now, for continuous random variable, this may have a decimal in it. Let's say, for example, the weight of the students. So, the weight of the students vary from one another. So, there are, let's say, 35.4 or some may have 40.5. So, it can have decimal in it. So, next. Probability distribution is a table showing the probabilities of various outcomes of an experiment. Just what I have said a while ago. So this present all the probabilities of the expected outcomes. It may come in list, or if it is tabulated, it is also called the probability distribution table. Probability distribution for a random variable describes how the probabilities are distributed over the values of random variable. For a discrete random variable x, the probability distribution is defined by the probability mass function. For discrete random variable, it is represented by small letter x, or sometimes it is also represented by the capital letter x, and its probability mass function is represented by p close and open parenthesis x. X is the desired or expected outcome, and p close and open parenthesis x, or the probability of x, is the probability of the expected outcomes in the experiment. Probability function for a discrete random variable must meet the following conditions. First, the probability of x must be non-negative for each value of the random variable. Since it takes, or shall we say, the probability of the outcomes must be non-negative, it is usually in a form of fraction or percent, so it must be non-negative. So second, the sum of probabilities for each value of the random variable must be equal to 1, or the summation of the probabilities is equal to 1. Therefore, each of the probability must be greater than or equal to 0, but less than or equal to 1. So, just like for example, when rolling a dice. So, there are 6 faces of the dice. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Each of the faces of the dice, the probability that it will come out when you roll a dice is 1 over 6. 1 because there is only one way for each number to be drawn when rolling it. So let's have example number 1. A pair of coin was tossed once. Let x be the number of tail that will come out. So first, we have to find all the possible outcome. Then second, find the probability that one tail will come out, then construct a probability distribution for x, or for the number of tail that will come out. So we have the solution. So x is the number of tail. So these are all the possible outcome. So when tossing a pair of coin, we may come out with both heads, or it may be head and the other one is tail, or we can have a tail and the other one is head, or we can have both tails. So second, to summarize all the possible outcomes, so we have the no tail. So when tossing a coin, then two heads appear, so we have no tail. So we have one possibility that it will come out, or it is 1/4. Or 25% that it will come out. Then for one tail, there are two possible outcomes that one tail will come out. So that is 2/4, or 1/2, or it is 50% probable that it will come out. Then the probability that two tail will come out is only 1, or it is 1/4, or 25% probable. So therefore, the probability that one tail will be drawn from tossing two coins is 1/2, or 50%. So to construct the probability distribution table, so we have x. So x here represent the number of tails that will come out, then px, or the probability distribution function. So we have 0 tails. So the 0 tail is 1/4, or 25% that it will come, no tail will come out. So for one tail, we have 1/2, or 50% that one tail will come out when tossing two coins. And for two tails, there is only one-fourth or 25% that two tails will come out when tossing two coins. Let's have another example. So two dice are rolled. Let X be the sum of two dice. So when tossing two dice, the maximum sum of the two dice when we roll it is 12. So we got 6 and 6. So what is the probability of getting the sum of 2, 3, 4, then up to 12? So 2 is the minimum sum when rolling two dice when we got 1 and 1. So this is the probability distribution for example number 2 when we roll two dice. So the maximum sum of two dice is 12. Now how do we get 2? So we only have one way of getting 2. That's 1 and the other one dice is 1. What about 3? How do we get the sum of 3 when rolling two dice? So we have 2 and 1 and 1 and 2. So the other dice could be 2 and the other is 1 or the other way around. What about getting the sum of 4? There are 3 ways of getting the sum of 4. And that would be the other dice is 1 and the other is 3 or the other way around. The other one is 3 and the other is 1. Or it could be 2 and 2. Both dice are 2. What about 5? How do we get the sum of 5 when rolling 2 dice? So we have 1 and 4, or it could also be the other way around, 4 and 1. Or we also have 2 and 3, that's also 5, and 3 and 2. What about the sum of 6? So when getting the sum of 6, we have 2 and 4 or 4 and 2. We also have 1 and 5, 5 and 1, or we have 3 and 3. So let's proceed with the sum of 12. So just what I have said a while ago, there's only one way of getting the sum of 12. This is mistaken, so that will be 6 plus 6, that's not 12 plus 12. Okay? So the probability of getting when you roll two dice, the probability that we will get less than or equal to 4, the sum of two dice is 1 over 6. So that would be all for our discussion this evening. Thank you for listening. If you have questions, you may replay this video, or if you have queries, you may directly ask question through chat or in our GC. So these are our references. So that would be all for this evening. Thank you everyone for listening.